Okay, good morning, everybody. Probably many of you don't know me, but I'm the extension entomologist here in Princeton. And the presentation today will deal with ambrosia beetles, the phenology and efficiency of pyrethroids. So Dr. Bessing from Lexington participated in this project also, as well as Winston Dunwell. And most of the work actually was conducted by Dr. Zenaida Viloria here in my lab. So ambrosia beetles are a group of very small beetles that belong to the Curculionidae. In the past, this group was in a separate family, but now they are there together with the weevils. So more species are important in forest ecosystems because they decompose the wood and that's part of the ecosystem. So, and in addition to that, all these species are associated in a mutualistic form with the fungi, with the fungus. So when they go into the wood, these insects carry the fungus in the body, actually in the upper portion of the body. There is a dissection here of the head, and you can see that the fungus is preserved in these areas of the body. So ambrosia beetles studies have not been conducted in nursery crops and orchards in Kentucky in recent years. So since 2016, I was able to participate in this project with Dr. Dunwell. And what we are going to tell you is that these invasive ambrosia beetles have shown moderate damage on apple orchards and landscape plants. And I say moderate because when they affect these plants, and if the plants are old, you can prune the plants and then you can save the plants. But also in addition to that, if the plants are old, they can still survive for a while. However, in nursery crops and apples that are really tiny, if these plants are affected, they can be plants can be killed very rapidly. In addition, also in nursery crops, the price of they don't need to have any damage due to this pest, and the prices can completely be reduced. In addition to that, also these beetles target stressed plants, plants that come from the winter, and they show some kind of weakness. They are targeted by these beetles because these plants are releasing ethanol, and ethanol is a volatile that attracts these beetles. So in nurseries, they do a preventative spray with pyrethroids around the end of March, April, and so on. So, but that's the strategy with these beetles. So the objectives of this study were first to identify the species and what are the phenology of the most important pests, the most abundant species. Also to determine the efficacy of pyrethroids, so we don't know which ones are better. In addition to that, I'm working closely with a colleague here in Paducah that he produces vinegars. And we tested two vinegars to see what are the effect on the ambrosia beetles. So in 2018 and 2019, this study was conducted only in Princeton. This is in Western Kentucky. And in 2019, we worked with Dr. Bessing, and we did some sampling of them in Lexington. So, you can see here how did we attracted these ambrosia beetles. We set up these traps that in the base have a glycol, and then on the top we have a high release ethanol pouches. So and these the beetles come attracted to that one, go into these pouches and then fall into the water, and that's how it's killed. So the results I'm going to show you is our sampling on this year. So what we have here is all the species of ambrosia beetles that we captured between 2016 and 2018. And this is only in this western part of the state. So you can see here that there are 8 invasive species and 9 native species. In addition to that, what's important also in these samples was that there were three species that were kind of the most effective, and they are here in yellow, okay? And you also can see that in Graves County, most of these species were present. Now, here is the phenology of these three most important species. You can see here the granulated ambrosia beetle on top, the camphor short, the middle, and the black stem borer on the bottom. So also in addition to that, you can see the difference on size of these insects. This is on millimeters. So you can see here the granulated, here this one, the little brownish one, and the tiny one, the black stem borer are really tiny, less than 2 millimeters in length, whereas the camphor short border is larger. However, this is not as abundant. If you see here this graph, you can see that the granulate border captures reach up to 70 per trap per week. So and these were basically by in 2017 were around the end of April. So we have the similar kind of data for 2018 and 2019. So this is kind of a example that these beetles are abundant during this period of time. So all this information can be found on in the Entomofacts 459. Okay, so how here is how we did the experiment to see the effects of the pyrethroids. So we cut an apple ball, so that was 30 centimeters long, and it has 3 to 4 centimeters diameter. And then we drill a hole on the top. The drill was maybe 5 centimeters here on the middle of the ball. And then we fill that with 3 to 4 millimeters of 95% ethanol. So, and this is to attract the beetles. Then we seal that hole with parafilm and also with wax, and we put wax on top and on the bottom because the alcohol usually run all the way down. So we sealed it very well. So and this table shows you the treatments: the Baytroid, Mustang, Max, Warrior. Those are the three pyrethroids, and we use the rates that were established by the manufacturer. Also, we have two types of vinegar. One was a hardwood vinegar, and the other one's a crotok vinegar. And of course, we have the control. So we dip these balls in the solutions, and then we left them for 10 or 20 days. And you can see here on the desk. And then we left in these containers, and we collected whatever was coming then. So also we count how many holes they have, okay? And you can see here the results. For 2018, you can see the number of attack logs were really high percentages for the ethanol, so it attracts a lot, that was the control. Whereas the Mustang has no attack, Mustang Max, and Baytroid has some very high attacks. So a hardwood wood and croton vinegar also have some kind of percentages of attack. So on the bottom, you see the numbers. These are not percentages, the numbers of attacks once they were in the lab. And then you also see the mean of granulated ambrosia beetle that emerged from each of these blocks. This is the means. So and you can see here that the largest was the hardwood vinegar. And the, in spite of having very, very few attacks, okay, the two vinegars have very high numbers, whereas the Mustang Max was very low and the Baytroid was not different from the control. So based on this one, we kind of theorizing, we hypothesize that maybe these hardwood vinegars, probably they are, instead of protecting the plants, actually they are attracting the plants, and maybe the plants develop, or the attracting the beetles, and the beetles start to reproduce a better way when you use these products. So this is something that we are still evaluating. So these are the results in 2019, and you can see here this Princeton in the left, Lexington on the right, and you can see here the pyrethroids. Mustang Max in Princeton was had show lower attacks compared to the other two predators, and in Lexington, Warrior was the best one. Okay, and again here the control and the vinegars have 100% of attack. Now, here is the number of attacks per log. So you can see here that the attacks can be very superficial, but then when you go into to collect the attacks that the you see dot in the laboratory, you see that the pyrethroids have very low attacks, and the hardwood and the control have higher. In 2019, probably they were not high numbers of ambrosia beetles flying in Princeton. But if you look into Lexington, you can see that we have very high numbers on the hardwood and the controls, whereas the pyrethroids really have a good protection. So, but again, Mustang Max in both cases during the 2 years worked the best. Now, these are the ambrosia beetles species that we collected from these tramps. And the most abundant was the granulated ambrosia beetle, followed by the camphor shot borer and the black stem borer. So these are the same species that were more abundant in our trapping collection. Okay, as a conclusion, I can tell you that we have 8 of each native and invasive ambrosia beetle species in Kentucky. Some of them actually were detecting for first time in Kentucky. Zeta cypermetrin or Magnimax was the most consistently pyrethroid to reduce the attacks. And again, in the traps, collecting in traps, and also using the using the apple logs, three species were the most abundant: the granulated ambrosia beetle, the camphor shot borer, and the black stem borer. In spite of that, it means all the pyrethroids reduced the presence of ambrosia beetles. Now, the hardwood vinegar did not deter ambrosia, so we tried to do the experiment, but instead actually increase the populations. We are still evaluating with a colleague from Ohio on what's really the effect of this vinegar. And we don't know what's going on. So only to show you this picture, this is the majestic symptom that you see on the plants that are affected. So when the ambrosia beetle drills into the plant, it's still to it removes the sawdust, and the sawdust has that appearance, or the plant has that appearance. Okay, that's all. If you have any questions, I can be able to answer some of them. Thank you.